Hello and aloha, and welcome to Music 102, World Music Cultures, Module 6, Session 2, entitled Core Traits of West African Drumming and Singing. So already you can remember from our previous session when I talked about reductionism, when I talked about core traits, I discussed that as a way for us to get a little window into this culture. And you can go all the way back to the beginning of the course when we talked about compiling a photo album. We're beginning now in a different culture, in a different geocultural area of the world, to compile more photos, more snapshots of that culture through reductionism, through looking at representative performances of representative genres in those representative cultures. So forgive me for emphasizing that time and time again, but I think it's very important for us. So as we go on and we look at what core traits are present here, and we will watch 2 minutes of a video and then try to list as many musical traits as we can based on the last session. Okay, after watching 2 minutes of that video, have you written some things down? Can you remember things from the last session? First, we have complex rhythmic interplay. Remember some other terms we talked about last time? Rhythmic ambiguity, rhythmic complexity. So that idea of layering rhythms and alternating rhythms and making them very complex. The idea of timeline plus variations. We have some repeated rhythmic patterns. We have some patterns that are varied or improvised and changed. Rhythmic ostinatos. Remember that word? What does ostinato mean? It's an Italian word that means a repeated musical pattern, something that's stubborn, something that's obstinate. It keeps coming back. Melodic ostinatos, which can come from the vocal in that video, and the marimba, the wooden bar idiophone, multiple timbres in membranophones and idiophones. Remember that idea? The African aesthetic enjoys mixing a lot of different timbres into one performance. Now, you don't need to use those exact words, but as long as you can convey the general idea. So I would hope that our students, after you've had a chance to watch that video, after you've had the previous session, previous discussion, that you would be able to jot down ideas like this, even if you didn't use those exact words. So let's focus on two of those traits now and look at them a little more deeply. So we will watch 3 minutes of the video that comes up in the link, and we're going to focus on two things. First of all, the vocal aesthetic. The idea of a rough edge timbre preferred over smoother ones. And again, I give you some names here that some of you might be familiar with, some of you might not. But if you know these names, it's more like Macy Gray as an R&B singer than it is like Norah Jones. And it's more like Bono from U2, the lead singer for U2, than it is like Jason Mraz, who recently had a hit with I'm Yours. The other thing to listen for, besides the rough edge vocal aesthetic, is a call and response between the soloist and the group. So the lead singer will alternate with the group, and the backup singers, when they get into it, they're singing a lyric over and over again, "Help me, Lord, I'm feeling low." So watch the first 3 minutes, and then we can make some comments and make some connections here. Okay, did you hear those things? Did you hear the rough edge, especially from the lead singer? Did you hear that call and response? Let's move on then. Let's look at two more traits. And then I've introduced this term here on this slide, Africanisms. That's a term that an author named John Storm Roberts used in a famous book several decades ago. And I use it just to create this term that describes all these core traits. So we might talk about call and response as an Africanism. We can talk about rough edge vocal timbres as an Africanism. So we're going to watch a video coming up in this link, and we're going to focus on two more things. And first of all, you'll notice in the photo on this slide, we have Angelique Kidjo. Hopefully you recognize her from the last session and the last video there. Her hair looks a little bit different here, but this is Angelique Kidjo. And many of you will recognize Alicia Keys, a well-known American R&B singer. And they're collaborating on something that's a mix of traditional African and modern African American. Now, this video you're going to see has another Western collaborator, Joss Stone, who I mentioned before. And so we're going to focus on another Africanism here, social commentary in text themes. And I don't believe we discussed that in a previous session. So zero in on this one. Traditional African music, singing, chanting, has an element of making social commentary. It might be about political relationships. It might be about relationships within the village. It might be kind of gossip. It might be expressing emotions and getting them out in the open. So this idea of social commentary. Now, in this context, it's the lyrics to an old Rolling Stones classic. Rolling Stones, of course, a British rock and roll band from the 60s, and they're still going strong. And the lyrics to this have been changed to bring awareness to the African refugees who need shelter. So the song is Gimme Shelter, which meant a certain thing in an emotional relationship for the Rolling Stones back in the 60s, and it means a different thing to Angelique Kidjo in the new millennium and the problem of African hunger. And you'll see this in the video as you watch. The other trait I want you to zero in on is melodic improvisation. So even if you don't know the original Rolling Stones song, you will hear a certain melody established by Angelique Kidjo, by Joss Stone. But if you listen carefully and listen for the subtle nuance here, you will hear both those singers changing the melody of the sections of the song here as the song progresses. And especially, as I point out to you here, especially Joss Stone changing and embellishing the original melody when she gets to the third chorus. Oh children, it's just a shout away. So listen for that.
Oh,
Okay, so in that video, Give Me Shelter, Angélique Kidjo, Joss Stone, you heard many Africanisms, but we were focusing that time on the social commentary of African hunger, and we were focusing on the melodic embellishment by the singers. Now, moving on, the most recognizable trait of all, probably, in African music is a rhythmic complexity. You notice a photo here which shows you different membranophones of different sizes. You see some idiophones in the background. And so we have a West African drumming ensemble in this photo with multiple timbres and going to create rhythmic complexity with the patterns that they put together. So layers of rhythm patterns, multiple tunings and timbres, rhythmic ostinatos or repeated patterns, which we could also call timelines, and then variations on that time on those timelines, improvised and changing patterns. In this video, you'll first see a performer on the left rear improvising, and it's a little bit hard to see because he's partially blocked. Then you'll see a performer on the right pick up the variations, and then the variations go back to the guy on the left rear again. You also see and hear and experience alternation or layering of duple groupings and triple groupings. Remember that that's sometimes called rhythmic conflict or polyrhythm or rhythmic ambiguity or rhythmic complexity. The same idea explained in different terms. So let's watch this West African drumming video from Senegal, and then we can highlight some of those things. Did you experience all those different elements we saw in the bullets here? The layers of rhythm patterns, multiple tunings and timbres. Now that group was all membranophones, of course, so you didn't get as many timbres as you get sometimes when you have shakers and metal bells and things like that. Rhythmic ostinatos, hopefully you heard those repeated patterns. And then the variations, and I think it's especially clear when the drummer on the right of the video begins to do the variations. To me, on this video, that's very clear. Hopefully it was to you as well. Alternation or layering of duple and triple groupings, that's a little bit harder to get out of that video, but it's there. And then that idea of rhythmic conflict or polyrhythm, many rhythms going on at once.